Hey everyone, we've got Aari McDonald here. If you have a question for her, please raise your hand. I'll call on you. Kim Doss, we'll start with you. Go ahead.
Hi, Aari. Welcome back to Arizona. There have been a lot of uncertainties this year in your rookie year, the change in coaches, all that kind of thing. How have you kind of kept focused and kept that from not getting into your head?
I came in my rookie year wanting some goals and just to, I know what I have for myself. And just always, I was just telling myself to stay positive. And I just got to think, you know, maybe sometimes change is good. And I think that, hey, we're all embracing it. It might be hard, but we're embracing it. And right now everything is up for us.
PJ Brown, go ahead.
Hi, Aari. What does it feel like to come back to Arizona? A lot of people are coming up from Tucson to see you to play tomorrow and to come back as a professional.
I am really excited to be back in Arizona. I posted a tweet yesterday, and even before I came, everyone's been texting me, hitting me up, Twitter, all that. So I'm just really excited to come back as a professional in one of my favorite states. So, you know, hopefully we get the dub. That'd be even better.
Brandon Sudge, go ahead.
Hey, Aari. So I know over the last couple of weeks, we kind of talked about how the energy in practice is kind of different from what it was. Can you kind of like highlight a moment or a certain thing that you remember that kind of just felt different, felt looser, felt lighter, that kind of.
Brandon, you're back. Can you repeat that?
Did it cut out halfway through, or do you need me to say the whole thing again?
Kind of towards the end.
Okay, so I was just saying, like, yeah, like, what was something that you remember in terms of, like, where you felt looser and lighter and where you guys were able to kind of realize this is, like, a whole new start here in the second half?
I would probably say the first day we came back. Coming in, everyone knew this was a mini training camp for us, but just from the start, out the gate, the first day, everyone has so much energy, everyone holding themselves accountable, just picking each other up when we were down, just communicating. And it's like, we've been having that. It's been contagious the whole couple of weeks we've been back. And so I'm really excited for it to translate to the game tomorrow.
Damian Alameda, go ahead.
Aari, what is life like as a professional?
Life has been great as a professional. You have so much freedom. And I love it. I've been able to just do stuff with my teammates, hang out, schoolwork, all that. So it's exciting.
Jeff Metcalf, go ahead.
Yeah, I wondered about that too, this transition to being a pro. What's been the biggest learning curve for you?
The biggest learning curve for me, I'll have to say, just speaking up, being vocal. I was going uphill. You know, I was vocal at Arizona. I had to be. And it's like I came to the league and it's like, okay, like I'm back quiet. But I think that after just talking to my teammates, they like, you know, you could lead as well. And I'm like, I'm just a rookie. They're like, no, like you can lead, like speak up, we'll listen to you. So I'm like, okay, that gave me the confidence to speak up and be more vocal as a leader, even as a rookie.
PJ, we'll go back to you.
So, you know, there's been, you've gone through this transition from college to pro and through, you know, you're on your third coach and a lot of different things are going on. You know, you always seem to have that mindset where no matter what, you go in and you do your job. So whether you...
PJ, I'm sorry, you can continue now.
Okay. You, whether you played 40 or 5 minutes, you've been able to come in, do your thing, be strong and perform like we all know that Aari performs. What's been your mindset behind that?
My mindset, like thus far in my rookie year, just be positive, be a sponge. And when your number is called, you go in there and do your job. And I think that's what make me, you know, that's what's keeping me like kind of like straight, like on a path, just staying a course. I've been telling myself, just stay positive, be a sponge, you know. So when you get in the game, do things, you know, do the little things. talk, be a passionate defensive end, just stuff like that. So, I mean, just basically tell myself to be positive and just stay ready.
Emmanuel Glaze, go ahead.
Yeah, this has been a tale of two seasons. You had your first season, you had your break, and now you're going into the second season. What can you take from that first part, what you've learned, what you played, now going into the second season for you? And it's still in your rookie year, but you know, as they say, if you play your first game, you're not a rookie no more. That you have learned from it, what you can take from it, and what you can do for the team going forward in the second half.
Just, you know, now with the second half starting tomorrow, just be ready when you come in, be more vocal. I've definitely got more comfortable with my teammates. And so I'm able to use my voice more and communicate offensively and defensively. So just be more vocal as a point guard. And also just don't be afraid, you know, to play your game, play free.
Kim Doss, back to you.
Talking about development, I saw you signed with the team in Hungary for the European season. What are you expecting when you go to Europe? What are you looking forward to? And did you talk to Dominique? I know she played in that league last year.
Yes, I am really excited and very fortunate to play in Hungary. I'm just excited. You know, I'm expecting, you know, to win. I mean, I'm going down there to get better, work on my game, and also just win and just get outside my comfort zone, explore a little bit, learn the Hungarian culture. And just, I have talked to Dominique. She texted me last week about her experience. And so she definitely eased my nerves a bit. So I'm really excited to go.
Damian, back to you.
Ari, how much have you leaned on Adia over the last few months? And what have those conversations been like?
Yeah, Coach Adia and I, we talk almost every day. And I got to see her when she was recruiting Atlanta. So, I mean, it's been amazing. She's been sharing, quotes from me every day, or almost every day, and just stay positive, stay encouraged, and just always be professional, do your job, go in there and, you know, play your game. And I think that's been helping me a lot. And I'm really excited to see her and everyone tomorrow.
PJ, back to you.
What would you say is your biggest growth point over the last few months? How has your game changed and grown, or you as a person?
My game has grown, I would say, just by like knowing the personnel of my teammates, knowing on which plays, which side somebody's supposed to be in, or who do I want like coming off the ball screen and stuff like that. So just knowing my personnel, my teammates, knowing where they're most successful at. So I think that's where I've grown. And shout out to my vets, the guards, Courtney. You got Odyssey. They always talk to me, and I'm just like, that's very helpful.
Last couple questions here. Jeff Metcalf, we'll go back to you. Go ahead.
You haven't played the Mercury yet this season. What did you take out of watching the Mercury players at the Olympics, and just how do you feel about playing this first time against them?
I'm really excited to play the Mercury. They have a great point guard in Skylar Diggins, and she's a lefty as well. Very quick, very crafty. And obviously they have the force down there. They have Brittany Griner. So I'm excited to play against them. I know that it's going to be a tough game. It's going to be physical, a fast paced game. So I'm really excited to play against them. And I hope we get the dub tomorrow.
And last question, Emmanuel Glaze, back to you. Go ahead.
I know you've had a couple of different coaches, but the one consistent coach has been Coach Darius. What has he meant for you this year and going into the second half, knowing that he's your head coach? What has he given you, and what some of the things that he's helped you with to get you ready for the rest of the year?
Coach Darius has been helping me with play calls. He's been telling me just to survey the game. And he's just like, hey, if we don't have people back, he said, hey, you can go in transition, you can go, do your thing. But if, you know, as a player just said defensively, let's cause some. So he's been helping me a lot with realizing that. And just also just him giving me the confidence, texting me, just letting me know, hey, play your game. Don't play to mess up, because you'll end up messing up in the end. So he's like, just play your game, you'll be fine. So I think that's been really helpful.
All right, Ari, thank you so much.
Thank you.